for a brain. This is the second part on this topic. To watch the first part, click on the link above. Along with the cerebrum, forebrain also comprises of the olfactory lobes and the diencephalon. As we have discussed about cerebrum in the previous video, let's start with olfactory lobes. Olfactory lobes are paired, solid, club-shaped, and present ventrally, which means it can be seen through an inferior view. These lobes are covered by cerebral hemispheres dorsally. The olfactory lobes are formed by anterior swollen olfactory bulb and posterior narrow olfactory tract. This tract is connected to olfactory area in temporal lobe. These lobes are concerned with the sense of smell. When compared with animals such as dogs, humans have poor sense of smell. This is due to small size of olfactory lobes and less number of olfactory receptors. The next and the last part of forebrain is the diencephalon. Diencephalon is visible from the inferior side, and is present below the corpus callosum, and above the midbrain. It is a small part, and forms less than 1% of the total brain. Brain consists of spaces, or cavities in between. These cavities are filled with fluid. Diencephalon encloses one such cavity, known as the third ventricle, or the diacole. Diencephalon is further divided into three parts: the epithalamus, thalamus, and the hypothalamus. Epithalamus is the thin roof of diencephalon. It consists of anterior choroid plexus, which secretes CSF. It also gives projection to endocrine pineal body, which secretes serotonin and melatonin. While serotonin controls metabolic activities, melatonin controls melanin pigment metabolism. Next part is the thalamus. Thalamus is the thick lateral wall of diencephalon. It is large, oval, bilateral area of gray matter. Thalamus is connected to various parts of brain through reticular activating system. The two thalami are connected to each other by hubuncular commissure. Thalamus acts as gatekeeper to cerebrum. All sensory impulses towards cerebrum pass through thalamus, except smell. It acts as a relay station for motor and sensory impulses between spinal cord, brainstem, and different areas of cerebral cortex. Thalamus also regulates the presentation of emotions. The last part of diencephalon is the hypothalamus. It is the floor of the diencephalon, and it acts as a connection between nervous system and endocrine system. It gives out a downwards projection of infundibulum, called stalk of pituitary gland. Just like cerebrum, hypothalamus also has patches of gray matter, scattered between white matter, called the hypothalamic nuclei. Hypothalamus is commonly known as thermostat of the body, as it helps in temperature regulation. Behind the hypothalamus, there is a pair of small rounded nipple-like bodies, called mammillary bodies, or the corpora mammillares. Presence of these bodies is a peculiar feature of mammalian brain. The hypothalamus functions to maintain the equilibrium, that is, homeostasis. It also maintains coordination between nervous system and the endocrine system. Hypothalamus also secretes neurohormones, which influence the pituitary gland.